Hey everybody, coming to you from Gateway Classic Cars over here outside of St. Louis, Missouri. And today I thought I'd show you this 1978 Dodge Warlock pickup. You know, this is from the same time that they were building those Little Red Express trucks, and this is something very similar to those. And this is one of the nicest ones that I've come across, so I thought we'd take a look at it here. You can see it has a nice big chrome bumper up front. Of course, you have the Dodge badging in the grill. And the paint on this truck is particularly nice. You can see just how slick it is. And on these Warlock pickups, they had all this additional trim. You can see all the gold striping going down the sides there. And when I look at that reflection, you can see just how slick that paint is. Very impressive. It is riding on some American racing wheels with Hoosier white letter tires. Got your custom badges on the fenders. The glass looks good. Nice chrome mirrors as well. And it is a step side pickup, as you can see. They've added a little diamond tread plate accent there. Go ahead and take a look inside, and as you can see, the door panels look like new. Seats are looking sharp as well. It's got the bucket seats, and then it has a third seat there in the center, but as you can see, it folds over like an armrest. It's got a three-spoke wheel and a nice set of gauges. 100 mile per hour speedometer there, and then you have all your auxiliary gauges to the left there. So pretty much got everything covered. The dashboard looks like new, no cracking or anything. And they have added a tack below the dash there. Very nice. I mean, it's nice and clean in there. Very sharp. Here we'll continue on out back. You can see the fuel filler on the left side of the bed here. More of that pinstriping detail. I mean, this one's in beautiful shape. You can see it has a nice chrome step bumper out back. And of course it says Warlock on the tailgate. They have a nice set of chrome chains on the tailgate here. And of course they have the plastic cover to keep it from chipping the paint up. It does have dual exhaust with chrome tips. And the bed itself is completely redone as well. All new bed wood. And you can see it's obviously never hauled anything. Super clean. I mean, if you've been looking for one of these, this is definitely one of the nicest examples I've seen. Very impressive. And here, I'll go ahead and pop open the hood and we'll take a look under there. Alright, as you can see, it's looking really good under the hood here as well. I'm assuming this is either a 318 or a 360, but I don't have all the information in front of me, so I'll have to look that up for you. But it's nicely detailed. Nice chrome air cleaner up top, and that's sitting on a Demon 4-barrel carb. And that's on top of an Edelbrock aluminum intake, but they painted the intake to match the block and heads and everything. It's running the factory style exhaust manifolds. Looking pretty impressive. And actually the Little Red Express at the time, which is a very similar truck, was the fastest performance vehicle in America that year. And obviously these can run just as well if you've got a nice running 360 in there. But it's definitely a beautiful truck. Very nice. Alright guys, we're going to go ahead and fire it up so you can hear what it sounds like. Well,
Well, anyway, guys, I just thought you'd find that one interesting. As I get more information, I'll put that below the video for you. I'm going to check into it here and see if I can figure out what the displacement is on that engine for you. But I appreciate you watching and commenting and everything, and I'll see you later. Bye.